Aloha, I'm Kala'i Miller. It's a thing many of us take for granted, getting fresh, clean water into our homes. But for nearly a century, it's been the number one priority of the Honolulu Board of Water Supply. Turns out, getting water to your tap is a much longer process than you might think.
So the history of the Board of Water Supply as we currently know began in the year 1929. But prior to 1929, what was happening here on the island of Oahu is that there was a boom of artesian well drilling. The history of artesian wells on Oahu began in 1879 out in Ewa by a man named James Campbell. In a span of about 50 years after that, there was an explosion of well drilling, and it led to the depleting of the underground aquifer. And in the mid-1920s, Oahu was going through a heavy drought period. And there was a real scare that our fresh water resource would be depleted. So the government stepped in and they enacted the establishment of the Board of Water Supply. We operate and manage the water system for most of the island of Oahu. And we serve approximately 1 million people daily on the island by providing approximately 145 million gallons of water every day. Because we live on an island in the middle of the ocean, we are totally dependent on rain. And that's where our fresh water literally comes from. We literally live on a stone sponge. Our island will collect that rain, will soak into the ground. Our lava rock will percolate and clean and filter that water. But because it's literally a stone sponge, it will store and hold that water underground in huge aquifers. And then that's when the Board of Water Supply, we finally come in. We pull that water up out of the ground. It goes through a pipe, comes up the faucet of your house. From the time that rain falls at the top of our mountains, that water drop will take a trip that's about 25 years long before we pump it up. So we can say that we drink 25-year-old water here on the island of Oahu. But we can also say that 25-year-old water is one of the world's best. Here on the island of Oahu, we are 100% dependent on water from underground. Now, primarily, it's groundwater or water from the aquifers. That accounts for about 92 to 93% of our water. Now, the remaining part, the remaining 7 to 8%, comes from sources that are confined naturally in the mountains. One of our largest facilities that is known as a Dyke Tunnel here in Waiheke Valley. It is the single largest water source for windward Oahu that draws water. Now, it's interesting that this tunnel was built in the mid-1950s. This is the decade just following World War II. Now, during World War II, there was a huge influx of population growth. Simple fact is that the water system on the windward side at that time was just too small. They needed to find a major water source for the towns of Kaneohe and Kailua. And what our tunnels do is we dig horizontally right through, and when we find one of those solid rock walls, we know if we punch through that wall, on the other side, we're gonna find that natural compartment of water. And that's what we have here in Waiheke. The tunnel is actually 1,500 feet long. It's like the 5-foot ball fields. Our 24-inch water main, that's the pipe that is actually bringing the water out from the back of the tunnel. No electricity is required because everything is done by gravity flow. But right here at this particular point is actually a dike formation right here in this rock. So very simply, what happens is the geological formation of the island of lava flow upon lava flow happens. And because we still have active volcanoes in Hawaii, underground earthquakes would happen during the formation of the island. When the underground earthquake happens, ground would split. When that split happens, it would allow a finger of lava to fill that gap. So you can imagine right here, this formation split, a finger of lava flowed in, filled it in. And because that lava was really never exposed to air, gas bubbles never happened, and it cooled and hardened into solid rock, creating this dike stone. So when we get up to the bulkheads, you can imagine that's what happened. We drilled through that solid rock wall, and on the other side, in this compartment, in the cracks and crevices of the rock, water is being held or stored. When we get 1,500 feet in, we will come to two steel and concrete bulkheads. Those bulkheads will look something like a bank vault door, but where that wall and that bank vault door, it's the point where we broke through that compartment wall and into the water. The construction of that bulkhead, very simply, is we put that wall back, and that helps us keep the integrity of the natural compartment of water on the other side. With all the other tunnels that we have on our system, Waihe'e is the actual only one that we have the bulkhead in place. We use Waihe'e as a summer bank account. We all know here in Hawaii we have two seasons, wet and dry. So wet season comes and it rains. We let that water build up in the compartment naturally. So when dry season comes, we will have a source of water that will hopefully take us through the dry season, waiting for the wet weather or the rains to return.
Traditionally, water utilities operate very quietly. Most of the infrastructure is underground. You don't really see it. You just turn on the faucet in your home and clean, fresh water comes out. I think the number one thing that people can do is understand the value and importance of vai, or fresh water, for our community, for our lives. So cherish that water as a gift. So only use what you need and don't waste it. Almost anything you pour on the ground, chemicals or even waste, motor oil, if you pour it on the ground, eventually that could actually reach the underground aquifer. So everybody has a part, and together as a team, we accomplish the job of providing safe drinking water to our community. I would say, just remember, you know, kawai ola, water for life. Ola I kawai, water is life. So remember that when you look at the next glass of clean, fresh water and hold it up to the light, take a look at it and say, this is actually, it's actually like the lifeblood of our community. Because without clean, fresh water, we cannot survive on this island. So cherish this gift, treat it wisely.